methods that Jim Jones used in his cult, the People's Temple, are definitely classical mind control techniques. And according to a book by Michael Myers, which is called Was Jonestown a CIA Medical Experiment, his documentation leads him to conclude that actually Jonestown was run by the CIA. Prior to being Jonestown in the deep jungles of British Guiana, that site was actually under control of what was called the Shalom Project. This was a CIA program for training black mercenaries for warfare in Angola.
Congressman Ryan and the journalists arrived in Guyana on Tuesday, November 14, 1978.
For some time, Ryan had been a thorn in the side of the CIA. He had recently pushed through congressional legislation that curtailed the agency's covert foreign activities. As Ryan prepared for a first-hand look at Jonestown, he was joined by a State Department agent, Richard Dwyer. What he didn't know was that Dwyer was working undercover.
A man named Dwyer was the head of the CIA here. I mean, the CIA had a presence here. It was an unrevealed presence at the time.
The next day, 20 temple members decided they wanted to leave. In a haze of drugs, Jones' world began to fall apart.
As the party reached the airport, a man with a knife tried to stab Ryan. The congressman described the attack.
Yeah, he said something about rob and choke and kill and or knife. I don't know. But the obvious, what he said was he intended to kill him.
The party had now been joined by about 30 cult members who wanted to get away, and the enlarged party walked out towards the aircraft. Congressman Ryan went over to shake the pilot's hand. As the party waited, a tractor and trailer appeared in the background. Hidden men opened fire. Congressman Ryan, two reporters, and an NBC cameraman were killed. Several other journalists and defectors were injured.
One man who was not executed at the airstrip was Richard Dwyer, the undercover CIA man from the American Embassy, seen here peeling off from Ryan's party seconds before the tractor arrives. Where Dwyer was in the next few hours is key to one of the mysteries that still lies at the heart of the Jonestown tragedy. Having dealt with Congressman Ryan, Jones now turned his insanity on the temple's faithful. From his seat in the pavilion, Jones recorded the last desperate hour of the People's Temple. In front of him, more than 900 of his followers, who were surrounded by guards holding rifles and crossbows. For all but a few, there was no escape. Subsequent medical examinations revealed that many of the dead had been murdered, held down, and injected with cyanide. Jones himself was one of the last to die. A single gunshot to the head sometime around midnight. His killer has never been known. At 3:30 in the morning, when everyone was dead and several hours before anyone arrived, a radio message was sent from Jonestown using a secret CIA channel, reporting what it described as a mass suicide. This was the message that shaped our view of Jonestown for years to come, even though the best medical evidence suggests that most of those who died had been murdered. The question then becomes who sent that message. The only functioning radio in the area belonged to the local American intelligence officer, Richard Dwyer. Though he always denied going back to Jonestown that night, the last tape tells a very different story.
Take Dwyer on down to the East House. Get Dwyer out of here before something happens to him.
Though more than 900 Americans had died, Richard Dwyer and other U.S. Embassy officials would later receive medals and promotions. A multi-million dollar lawsuit was subsequently filed by Congressman Ryan's daughter and the relatives of those who died. The suit described the deaths as a massacre and alleged that Jones was an agent or operative of the Central Intelligence Agency. It was dismissed on a technicality and never tried. 20 years later, the CIA continues to deny any interest in the People's Temple. They claim that their own file on Jones is empty. But new evidence reveals startling connections between Jones and members of the U.S. intelligence community.
It began with a visit to Guyana by Congressman Leo Ryan, some of his staff, and members of the press. He was later killed, along with four other Americans, including Don Harris and Robert Brown of NBC News. After the killings, the Guyanese authorities impounded the first tapes and notes made by the NBC crew.
I appeared in Washington in February before the International Relations Committee and made some statements and some charges and documentation which resulted in the Foreign Affairs Committee, or International Relations Committee, whatever they call it today. They voted to ask the House Select Committee on Intelligence to investigate my charges, and they are currently investigating those charges by the House Select Committee on Intelligence.
Can you tell us what the charges are?
Well, the charges basically amounted to CIA contact with both the Burnham government there and with the People's Temple. That originally, it was my belief at the time I went to Washington that the purpose of our involvement there was to support the government of Burnham for commercial reasons, and they used the People's Temple almost as enforcers to help support an unpopular government there to keep control of the government of Guyana. We knew that there had been an article in the San Mateo Times in December of 79 which indicated that the deputy chief of mission there, Richard Dwyer, was in fact the CIA station chief. He was the one that went to Jonestown with Leo's party, and he claimed to be slightly wounded, but there was a tape made at the time of the murders and suicides there with Jones yelling, "Get Dwyer out of here, get Dwyer out of here." And the indications are that it was Dwyer who went back into Jonestown after Leo was murdered and was there at the time. And there's great questions, just who shot Jim Jones and why, whether Jones was shot to shut him up. The question also as to how all these people died and just when they died, which is all documented here. But soon I came back from Washington, because of my testimony, I started getting documentation from a Berkeley psychologist called the Penal Colony here, and from the Alliance for Preservation of Religious Liberty in Washington, which indicated other things, one of which was that George Philip Blakey was a top Jones aide. And he was the man who arranged the purchase or the lease of the land in Guyana, provided the money and arranged the lease down there in 1974. He also was tracked now as being a CIA operative in Angola in 1975 with UNITA. He's also the same guy who was a top aide who arranged all this purchase and the finances, is also the husband of Deborah Layton Blakey, who fled Jonestown and made those charges. He's a brother-in-law of Larry Layton, who was acquitted yesterday. And it's interesting to note, the Peninsula Times Tribune says, yesterday, the jury appeared to have agreed with the defense contention that Layton was brainwashed and drugged at the time of the shooting, could not be held criminally responsible. But the gist of what I'm getting to is this. I've received a lot of documentation, which I will value here today, that indicates the strong possibility that Jonestown and the People's Temple was in reality a mass mind control experiment conducted by the CIA as a follow-up to something called MKUltra, which they conducted from the early 50s through 1974. They used to use the VA hospital and state hospitals. They used the federal and state penitentiaries for their experiments.
Do you think that Jim Jones was actively involved with the CIA?
I do now.
Do you have any conclusions as to how the people died in Jonestown?
Yes, I have part of our documentation here is a report from which is attached here. The chief medical examiner in Guyana is a Dr. Leslie Moto. He reported, and this is attached here, his opinion that more than 700 of those bodies found at Jonestown were not suicide victims but were murdered. He based this on the injection marks in the upper arm. Page 4 of my statement here.
By injection, like that?
Yes, and by gunfire. There were a lot more people killed by gunfire than they've ever admitted so far. We have heard reports that there were 50 of them, about 50 men with guns ringing around there, so people couldn't get out, and very few of them did get out.
how very much I've loved you. How very much I've tried my best to give you the good life. But in spite of all of that I've tried, a handful of our people, with their lives, have made our life impossible. There's no way to detach ourselves from what's happened today. Not only we're in a compound situation, not only are there those who have left and committed the betrayal of the century, some have stolen children from others and they're in pursuit right now to kill them because they stole their children. And we are sitting here waiting on a powder keg. I don't think this is what we want to do with our babies. I don't think that's what we had in mind to do with our babies. It was said by the greatest of prophets from time immemorial, no man takes my life from me, I lay my life down. So to sit here and wait for the catastrophe that's going to happen on that airplane, it's going to be a catastrophe. It almost happened here. Almost happened. The congressman was nearly killed here. But you can't steal people's children. You can't take off with people's children without expecting a violent reaction. And that's not so unfamiliar to us either. Even if we were Judeo-Christian, if we weren't communists, the world, the kingdom, suffereth violence, and the violence shall take it by force. If we can't live in peace, then let us die in peace. We've been so betrayed. We have been so terribly betrayed. But we tried, and as Jack Beam often said, I don't know where he's at right this moment. Where's Jack? He said, if this only worked one day, it was worthwhile. Because what's going to happen here in a matter of a few minutes is that one of those people on that plane is going to shoot the pilot. I know that. I didn't plan it, but I know it's going to happen. They're going to shoot that pilot, and down comes that plane into the jungle. And we had better not have any of our children left when it's over, because they'll parachute in here on us. I'm telling you just as plain as I know how to tell you, I've never lied to you. I never have lied to you. I know that's what's going to happen. That's what he intends to do. And he will do it. He'll do it. Fortunately, being so bewildered with many, many pressures on my brain, seeing all these people behave so treasonous, it was just too much for me to put together. But I now know what he was telling me, and it'll happen. If the plane gets in the air, even. So my opinion is that we be kind to children and be kind to seniors and take the portion like they used to take in ancient Greece and step over quietly, because we are not committing suicide. It's a revolutionary act. We can't go back. They won't leave us alone. They're now going back to tell more lies, which means more congressmen. And there's no way, no way we can survive. Anybody wish? Anyone that has any dissenting opinion, please speak. Yes. You can have an opportunity, but if our children are left, we are going to have them butchered. We can make a strike, but we'll be striking against people that we don't want to strike against. We'd like to get the people who caused this stuff, and if some people here are prepared to know how to do that, to go in town and get Timothy Stone, but there's no plane. There's no plane. You can't catch a plane in time. He's responsible for it. He brought these people to us. He and Deanna Myrtle. But people in San Francisco will not be idle over this. They'll not take our death in vain, you know. Yes, Christine.
Is it too late for Russia?
Here's why it's too late for Russia. They killed. They started to kill. That's why it makes it too late for Russia. Otherwise, I'd said, Russia, you bet your life. But it's too late. I can't control these people. They're out there. They've gone with their guns, and it's too late. And once we kill anybody, at least that's the way I've always put my lot with you. If one of my people do something, it's me. Now they say, I don't have to take the blame for this, but I don't live that way. They said, deliver up Ujara, who tried to get the man back here. Ujara, whose wife, mother has been lying on him and trying to break up this family, and they've all agreed to kill us by any means necessary. You think I'm going to deliver them, Ujara? Not on your life. No. No, you're not going. You're not going. You're not going. I can't live that way. I cannot live that way. I've lived with for all, and I'll die for all. I've been living on hope for a long time, Christine, and I appreciate you've always been a very good agitator. I like agitation because you got to see two sides of one issue, two sides of a question. But what those people are going to get done, what they get through, will make our life worse than hell. Will make the Russians not accept us. When they get through lying, they told so many lies between there and that truck that we are done in as far as any other alternative.
Well, I said let's make an airlift to Russia. That's what I say. I don't think nothing is impossible.
Well, how are we going to
believe it?
How are you going to airlift to Russia?
Well, I thought they said if we got in an emergency, they gave you a code to let them know.
No, they did. They gave us the code that they'd let us know of an issue, not us create an issue for them. They said if they saw the country coming down, they'd give us the code. They'd give us the code. You can check on there and see if it's on the code. You can check with Russia to see if they'll take us in immediately, otherwise we die. I didn't know what else you say to these people. But to me, death is not a fearful thing. It's living this treachery. I have never, 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 never seen anything like this before in my life. I've never seen people take the law in their own hands and provoke us and try to purposely agitate murder of children. Christine, it's just not. It's not worth living like this. Not worth living like this.
I think that there were too few who left for 1,200 people to give them their lives for those people that left.
You know how many left?
20 odd. That's a small
20 odd.
Compared to what's here.
20 odd. But what's going to happen when they don't leave? I hope that they could leave, but what's going to happen when they don't leave?
You mean the people here?
Yeah, what's going to happen to us when they don't leave, when they get on the plane and the plane goes down?
I don't think it'll go down.
You don't think it'll go down? I wish I could tell you were right, but I'm right. There's one man there who blames, and rightfully so, Debbie Blakey for the murder of his mother, and he'll stop that pilot by any means necessary. He'll do it. That plane will come out of the air. There's no way you fly a plane without a pilot.
I wasn't speaking about that plane. I was speaking about the plane for us to go to Russia.
To Russia. Do you think Russia's going to want... You think Russia's going to want us with all this stigma? We had some value, but now we don't have any value.
Well, I don't see it like that. I mean, I feel like that as long as there's life, there's hope. That's my faith.
Well, everybody dies. Someplace that hope runs out because everybody dies. I haven't seen anybody yet didn't die. And I like to choose my own kind of death for a change. I'm tired of being tormented to hell. That's what I'm tired of. Tired of it. 1,200 people's lives in my hands, and I certainly don't want your life in my hand, but I'm going to tell you, Christine, without me, life has no meaning. I'm the best friend you'll ever have. Once I have to pay, I'm standing with you, Jara. I'm standing with those people. They're part of me. I can detach myself. My attorney says detach myself. No, 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 no. I never detached myself from any of your troubles. I've always taken your troubles right on my shoulders. And I'm not going to change that now. It's too late. I've been running too long. Not going to change now. Maybe the next time you get to go to Russia, the next time around. This is what I'm talking about now is in the dispensation of judgment. This is the revolutionary, suicide council. I'm not talking about self-destruction. I'm talking about what we have no other road. I will take your call. We will put it to the Russians, and I can tell you the answer now because I'm a prophet. Call the Russians and tell them, see if they'll take us.
Not that I'm afraid to die.
I don't think you are. I don't think you are.
But I look at our babies and I think they deserve to live.
I agree.
You know?
But also they deserve, what's more, they deserve peace.
We all came here for peace.
And have we had it?
No.
I tried to give it to you. I've laid down my life practically. I've practically died every day to give you peace. And you still not had any peace. You look better than I've seen you in a long while. But it's still not the kind of peace that I wanted to give you. So, a person's a fool that continues to say that you're a winner when you're losing. Win one, lose two. What? I didn't hear you, ma'am. You have to speak up. That's a sweet thought. Who said that? Come on up and speak it again, honey. Come up and say it about what I talk about. It's taken off. No plane is taken off. It's suicide. They have done it. Stone has done it. Somebody ought to, somebody, can they talk, can they not talk to San Francisco? See, the Stone does not get by with this infamy. This is infamy. He has done the thing he wanted to do, to have us destroyed.
When we destroy ourselves, we're defeated. We let them, the enemy, defeat us.
Did you see I live to fight no more forever?
Yes, I saw that.
Did you not have some sense of pride and victory in that man? He would not subject himself to the will and whim of people who tell that they're going to come in whenever they please and push into our house, come when they please, take who they want to, talk to who they want to. Is that living? That's not living to me. That's not freedom. That's not the kind of freedom I sought.
But I think where they made their mistake is when they stopped to rest. If they had gone on, they would have made it. But they stopped to rest.
It's over, sister. It's over. We've made that day. We made a beautiful day. And let's make it a beautiful day. That's what I want.
We win when we go down. Tim Stone has nobody else to hate. He has nobody else to hate. Then he'll destroy himself. I'm speaking here not as the administrator. I'm speaking as a prophet today. I wouldn't step in this seat and talk so serious if I didn't know what I was talking about. If there's any way to call back the immense amount of damage that's going to be done. But I cannot separate myself from the pain of my people. And you can't either, Christine, if you stop to think about it. You can't separate yourself. We've walked too long together.
I know that, but I still think as an individual, I have a right to...
You do, and I'm listening.
...what I think, what I feel, and I think we all have a right to our own destiny as individuals.
Right.
And I think I have a right to choose mine, and everybody else has a right to choose theirs.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm. I'm not criticizing. I'm not doing that. What's that? Today. That's what 20 people said today with their lives.
I think I still have a right to my own opinion.
I'm not taking it from you. I'm not taking it from you.
Christine, you're only standing here because he was here in the first place. So I don't know what you're talking about, having an individual life. Your life has been extended to the day that you're standing there because of him.
Well, it's back there. She has as much right to speak to anybody else, too. What'd you say, Luby? Well, you'll regret it this very day if you don't die. You'll regret it if you don't die. You'll regret it.
Too many people?
I saved them, but I made my example. I made my expression. I made my manifestation, and the world was ready, not ready for me. Paul said, I was a man born out of due season. I've been born out of due season just like all we are, and the best testimony we can make is to leave this goddamn world.
Peace, peace.
I'm not talking to her. Will you let her let me talk?
You're talking.
You make her sit down and let me talk while I'm on the floor, or let her come?
Proper to tell the leader what to do. It really isn't. I've listened to you. You asked me about Russia. I'm right now making a call to Russia. What more do you suggest? I'm listening to you. If Russia gives me one slight bit of encouragement, I just now instructed them to go there and do that.
And you would be no fucking good in Russia, goddammit! No,
all right, now everybody, hold it. We didn't come. Hold it.
Much longer to maintain. To lay down your burdens. I'm going to lay down my burdens down by the riverside. So we lay them down here in the side of Guyana. What's the difference? No man didn't take our life right now. He hadn't taken it. But when they start parachuting out of the air, they'll shoot some of our innocent babies. I don't insist on this, Christy. Because they got to shoot me to get through to some of these people. I'm not letting them take your jar. Can you let them take your jar? What's that?
You mean you want to see John, the little one in Kenya?
I want to see... Peace.
Are you saying that you think he thinks more of them than other children here?
John.
That's what you're saying?
But you're acting. Do you think I'd put John's life above others? If I put John's life above others, I wouldn't be standing with his jar. I'd send John out, he could go out on the driveway tonight.
Because he's young, they're young.
I know, but he's no different to me than any of these children here. He's just one of my children. I don't prefer one above another. I don't prefer him above you, Jara. I can't do that. I can't separate myself from your actions or his actions. If you'd done something wrong, I'd stand with you. If they wanted to come and get you, they'd have to take me.
We're all ready to go. If you tell us we have to give our lives now, we're ready. I'm pretty sure all the rest of the brothers are with me.
For months I've tried to keep this thing from happening, but I now see it's the will of sovereign being that this happened to us. That we lay down our lives in protest against what's being done. That we lay down our lives to protest in what's being done. The criminality of people, the cruelty of people. Who walked out of here today? Did you notice who walked out? Mostly white people. Mostly white people walked. I'm so grateful for the ones that didn't, those who knew who they are. But there's no point to this. We are born before our time. They won't accept us. And I don't think we should sit here and take any more time for our children to be endangered, because they come after our children and we give them our children, then our children will suffer forever. I have no quarrel with you coming up. I like you. I personally like you very much.
These people get hostile when you try to...
Oh, well, some people do. But you just some people do. Put it that way. I'm not hostile. You had to be honest, and you stayed, and if you wanted to run, you'd have run with them, because anybody could have run today. They would want to. I know you're not a runner. And I, your life's precious to me. It's as precious as John's. And I do with weight and justice and judgment. I've weighted against all evidence.
Okay. That's all I got to say.
What comes now, folks? What comes now?
Everybody, hold it.
Stay peace. What's come? Don't let it. Just take Dwyer on down to the East House.
Take Dwyer. Everybody, be quiet, please.
So you've got some respect for our lives.
That means sit down.
I know. I tried so very, very hard. We're trying over here to see what can happen in Los Angeles. Who is it? Get Dwyer out of here before something happens to him. Dwyer? I'm not talking about you, Jara. I said Dwyer. Ain't nobody gonna take you, Jara. I'm not letting them take you, Jara. Gather in, folks. It's easy. Yes, my love.
At one time, I felt just like Christine felt. But after today, I don't feel anything because the biggest majority of the people that left here were white. And I know it really hurt my heart. Because
broke your heart, didn't it?
It broke my heart to think that all of these years that these white people have been with us and they're not a part of us. So we might as well end it now because I don't see...
Talking. The congressman has been murdered.
It's all over. What a legacy. But the Red Brigade's the only ones that ever made any sense anyway. They invaded our privacy. They came into our home. They followed us 6,000 miles away. The Red Brigade showed them justice. The congressman's dead. Please get us some medication. It's simple. There's no convulsions with it. It's just simple. Just please get it. Before it's too late, the GDF will be here. I tell you, get moving. Don't be afraid to die. If these people land out here, they'll torture some of our children here. They'll torture our people. They'll torture our seniors. We cannot have this. Are you going to separate yourself from whoever shot the congressman? I don't know who shot him. Speaker Pete and those had a right to go, and they had a right to... How many are dead? Oh, God Almighty, God Almighty. Patty Parks is dead.
Do you have the others to endure long enough in a safe place to write about the goodness of Jim Jones?
I don't know how in the world they're ever going to write about us. It's just too late. The congressman's dead. The congressman today's dead. Many of our traitors are dead. They're all laying out there dead. I didn't, but my people did. They're my people. And they've been provoked too much. What's happened here has been too, but this has been an act of provocation. Yes.
If it's any way possible to have them to give Ted something to take him, I'm satisfied, okay?
What's that?
I said, if it's any way you can do to have them to give Ted something so he won't have to let him go through, okay? And I'm satisfied.
That's fine. Ted, yes.
Because I said I never wanted to live with you guys. And I appreciate you for everything.
You're the only,
and I appreciate you. Okay.
Please, can we hasten? Can we hasten with that medication? You don't know what you've done. I tried. Move, please move. They saw it happen and ran in the bush and dropped the machine guns. I never in my life. But there'll be more. You got to move. Are you going to get the medication here? You got to move. Marcelin, there's about 40 minutes.
You have to move, and the people that are standing there in the aisle, go stay in the radio room yard. But everybody get behind the table and back this way, okay? There's nothing to worry about. Everybody keep calm and try and keep your children calm. And the older children can help love the little children and reassure them. Children aren't crying from pain. It's just a little bitter tasting, but they're not crying out of any pain. Annie McGowan, can I please see you back?
I used to do before I came here. So let me tell you about it. It might make a lot of you feel a little more comfortable. Sit down and be quiet, please. One of the things that I used to do, I used to be a therapist. And the kind of therapy that I did had to do with reincarnation and past life situations. And every time anybody had the experience of going into a past life, I was fortunate enough through Father to be able to let them experience it all the way through their death, so to speak. And everybody was so happy when they made that step to the other side.
When you step, there's no other thing you can do but step that way. It's the only way to step. That choice is not ours now. It's out of our hands.
If you have a body that's been crippled, suddenly you have the kind of body that you want to have.
A little rest.
It feels good. You've never felt so good, family, I tell you. You've never felt so good is how that feels.
And I do hope that those attorneys will stay where they belong and don't come up here. What is it? What is it?
Get what?
It's hard. It's hard. It's hard. Only at first. Only at first is it hard. It's hard only at first. Living, you're looking at death. It only looks. Living is much, much more difficult. Raising up every morning and not knowing what's going to be the night's bringing. It's much more difficult. It's much more difficult.
I just want to say something to everyone that I see that is standing around and crying. This is nothing to cry about. This is something we should all rejoice about. We should be happy about this. They always told us that we should cry when you're coming into this world. Well, when we're living and we're living it peaceful, I think we should be happy about this. I was just thinking about Jim Jones. He just has suffered and suffered and suffered. He is the only God, and he don't even have a chance to enjoy himself here. And I wanted to say one more thing. This is one thing I want to say. The excuse that's gone is many more here. That's not all of us. That's not all yet. That's just a few that has got a chance to get to the one that they could tell their story to, their lies to. So I'm looking at so many people crying. I wish you would not cry and just thank Father. Just thank him. I've been here about... I've been here 1 year and 9 months, and I never felt better in my life, not in San Francisco, but until I came to Jonestown. I've enjoyed this life. I've had a beautiful life. And I don't see nothing for us to be crying about. We should be happy. At least I am. Let's face one little thing.
Be alive today. I just like to thank Dad because he was the only one that stood up for me when I needed him. And thank you, Dad.
I'm glad you're my brothers and sisters, and I'm glad to be here. Okay.
Please, for God's sakes, let's get on with it. We've lived as no other people have lived and loved. We've had as much of this world as you're going to get. Let's just be done with it. Let's be done with the agony of it. It's far, far harder to have to watch you every day die slowly. And from the time you're a child to the time you get gray, you're dying. It's honest, and I'm sure that they'll pay for it. They'll pay for it. This is a revolutionary suicide. This is not a self-destructive suicide. So they'll pay for this. They brought this upon us. And they'll pay for that. I leave that destiny to them. Wants to go with their child has a right to go with their child. I think it's humane. I want to see you go though. They can take me and do with me whatever they want to do. I want to see you go. I don't want to see you go through this hell no more. No more, no more, no more. We're trying. If everybody will relax. The best thing you do to relax and you have no problem. You'll have no problem with the thing if you just relax.
With the children here, a great deal because of Jim Jones. And the way the children are laying there now, I'd rather see them laid like that than to see them have to die like the Jews did, which was pitiful anyhow. And I'd just like to thank Dad for giving us life and also death. And I appreciate the fact the way our children are going. Because like Dad said, when they come in, what they're gonna do to our children, they're gonna massacre our children. And also the ones that they take captured, they're gonna just let them grow up and be dummies like they want them to be. And not grow up to be a socialist like the one and only Jim Jones. So I'd like to thank Dad for the opportunity for letting Jonestown be not what it could be, but what Jonestown is. Thank you, Dad.
It's not to be feared. It is not to be feared. It's a friend. It's a friend. You're sitting there. Show your love for one another. Let's get calm. To us, we had nothing we could do. We can't separate ourselves from our own people. For 20 years laying in some old rotten nursing home. Taking us through all these anguish years. They took us and put us in chains, and that's nothing. There's no comparison to that, to this. They robbed us of our land, and they've taken us and driven us, and we tried to find ourselves. We tried to find a new beginning, but it's too late. You can't separate yourself from your brother and your sister. No way I'm going to do it. I refuse. I don't know who fired the shot. I don't know who killed the congressman. But as far as I'm concerned, I killed him. You understand what I'm saying? I killed him. He had no business coming. I told him not to come. Right. die with respect, die with a degree of dignity. Lay down your life with dignity. Don't lay down with tears and agony. There's nothing to death. It's like Max said, it's just stepping over in another plane. Don't be this way. Stop this hysterics. This is not the way for people who are socialists, communists to die. No way for us to die. We must die with some dignity. Soon we'll have no choice. Now we have some choice. You think they're going to allow this to be done and allow us to get by with this?
Must be insane.
But children, it's just something to put you to rest. Oh, God. Mother, 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 please. Mother, please, 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 don't do this, don't do this. Lay down your life with your child, but don't do this. Free at last. Peace. Keep your emotions down, keep your emotions down. Children, it will not hurt if you'll be quiet, if you'll be quiet. It's never been done before, you say. It's been done by every tribe in history, every tribe facing annihilation. All the Indians of the Amazon are doing it right now. They refuse to bring any babies into the world. They kill every child that comes into the world because they don't want to live in this kind of a world. So be patient, be patient. Death is, I tell you, I don't care how many screams you hear, I don't care how many anguished cries, death is a million times preferable to 10 more days of this life. If you knew what was ahead of you, if you knew what was ahead of you, you'd be glad to be stepping over tonight. Death, death, death is common to people. In the Eskimos, they take death in their stride. Let's be dignified. If you quit telling them they're dying, if you adults would stop some of this nonsense, adults, I call on you to stop this nonsense. I call on you to quit exciting your children when all they're doing is going to quiet rest. I call on you to stop this now, if you have any respect at all. Are we black, proud, and socialist, or what are we? Now stop this nonsense. Don't carry this on anymore. You're exciting your children. All over, and it's good. No sorrow that it's all over. I'm glad it's over. Hurry, hurry, my children, hurry. All I say, let's not fall into the hands of the enemy. Hurry, my children. Hurry. The seniors out here that I'm concerned about, hurry. I don't want to leave my seniors to this mess. Quickly, 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 quickly. Sisters, good knowing you. No more pain, Al. No more pain, I said, Al. No more pain. Jim Cobb is laying on the airfield dead at this moment. Remember, Oliver woman said she come over and kill me if her sons wouldn't stop her. These are people, the peddlers of hate. All we're doing is laying down our life. We're not letting them take our life. We're laying down our life. We're taking their lives. We just want peace.
All I'd like to say is that my so-called parents was filled with so much hate. Hate and treachery. I think you people out here should think about how your relatives was and be glad about that the children are being laid to rest. And all I'd like to say is I thank Dad for making me strong to stand with it all and make me ready for it. Thank you.
I can do them. All they're doing is taking a drink to go to sleep. That's what death is, sleep. But
tired of it. I'm tired of it all.
Loving thing he could have ever done, the most loving thing all of us could have done. And it's been a pleasure walking with all of you in this revolutionary struggle. No other way I would rather go than give my life for socialism, communism. And I thank Dad very, very much.
But that Dad's love and mercy and goodness and kindness and bringing us to this land of freedom, his love, his mother was the advance guard to socialism. And his love and his mercy should go on forever, onto the fields.
Where's the vat? Where's the vat with the green steam?
His love should go on forever, onto the fields of time. And thank you, Dad.
The vat with the green steam, please. Bring it here so the adults can begin. Beg you, don't fail to follow my advice. You'll be sorry.
You'll be sorry.
That we do it and that they do it. Us trust you, you have to step across. We used to sing this world's not our home. Well, it sure isn't. As we were saying, it sure wasn't. Yeah. He doesn't want to tell him. All he's doing, if they will tell him, assure these children. Can some people assure these children of the relaxation of stepping over to the next plane? We've set an example for others. We've set 1,000 people who say we don't like the way the world is. Take our life from us. We laid it down. We got tired. We didn't commit suicide. We committed an act of revolutionary suicide protesting the conditions of an inhumane world.